I may not always love you, but long as there are stars above you, you never need to doubt it. I'll make you so sure about it. God only knows what I'd be without you. If you should ever leave me, well, life would still go on, believe me. The world could show nothing to me, so what good would living do me? God only knows what I'd be without you. God only knows what I'd be without. God only knows what I'd be without. God only knows what I'd be without you. God only knows what I'd be without you. God only knows what I'd be without you. God only knows what I'd be without you, without you.
I used to go to Russia two or three times a year to lead mission teams to work in children's orphanages. It was really a wonderful experience. I liked going in the wintertime. It was so pretty, so much snow, and the cities were just beautiful. I remember the last time I went, I got back. And two or three days after I was back here, the district superintendent called me. And he said, "I need to talk to you." That's all he said. I thought, "Oh, what's this about?" Well, we met, and he said, "A couple of your team members have a complaint against you." And I thought, "Well, I wonder what that could be." And then he said this. He said, "They claim that you have favorites. They claim that you have favorites." And he looked at me and he said, "Do you have favorites?" And I said, "Yes. Yes. I mean, don't we all have favorites?" And I looked at him and I asked him a question. I looked straight in his eyes. And I said, "Do you have favorites?" And he said this. He said, "I try to treat everybody the same." I said, "Well, I do too." But I said, "That's not the question." I said, "Do you have favorites?" He didn't say a word. And then I looked at him, true story. I looked at him and I said, "Am I one of your favorites?" And he said something to the effect, "Well, I guess we're done here." And I said, "Yes, we are." Lord, forgive me, but he was a dingbat. Maybe still a dingbat. I think we all have favorites. We just don't want to admit it. I think each and every one of us have favorites. And I don't think that's a sin. I think that's okay. Sometimes we're not honest with ourselves. After the crucifixion and the resurrection of Jesus, about 40 days after that, Peter was in Jerusalem. Now, I don't know how this started. Nobody does. I know the Holy Spirit was upon Peter, but I don't know how it started. Peter was in Jerusalem, and maybe somebody asked him a question, because there was not designated times to stand and preach, okay? Maybe somebody asked Peter a question about Jesus. And Peter started talking about Jesus. He said, Jesus was the Messiah, God's anointed, the one you were looking for. You didn't believe him. You made false accusations about him. You handed him up to evil men. They crucified him. But on the third day, he rose from the dead. How did Peter know that? He probably said, I have seen him. We have seen him. He is risen. And by that time, probably there was a group that gathered. And they overheard what Peter was saying. And they cried out from the crowd, what must we do? How can we be forgiven? And Peter says this, repent and believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and be baptized. And you will be forgiven and you will be saved. And the scripture tells us that very day, 3,000, think of that, 3,000 people were baptized. That's the largest recorded baptism in history until May. In May, get a load of this, in May, in California, Greg Laurie, an evangelical preacher, a 70-year-old preacher, baptized 4,500. And you know, I haven't listened to his sermon. I haven't watched the video. It's online where he baptized these people. But I'd almost bet that Greg Laurie referenced Peter. I almost bet that he says, this is how you are forgiven, and this is how you are saved. Repent your sin and believe upon the Lord Jesus Christ, and you are saved. And he baptized 4,500 people. Think of that. Have you heard that? Probably not. You don't hear those gospel things on the nightly news, but that's something. That's something we need to talk about. You know, I worry about the church. I worry about the church. The church seems to me it's involved in too many things. They're talking about too many things, too many things. And a lot of those things are not relevant to the gospel. I worry about the church. Numbers keep going down. I worry about this video. Numbers keep going down. If I could do anything about that, I would. The church should be about the business. Listen to this. My mother used to say this. The church should be about the business of saving souls in the name of Jesus. Think about it. Peter baptized 3,000 people in one day. People talked about that back then. Did you hear what happened? Greg Laurie, evangelical pastor in California, in May baptized 4,500 people in the name of Jesus.
I may not always love you, but long as there are stars above you, you never need to doubt it. I'll make you so sure about it. God only knows what I'd be without you. If you should ever leave me, well, life would still go on, believe me. The world could show nothing to me, so what good would living do me? God only knows what I'd be without you. Go on, believe me. The world could show nothing to me. So what good would living do me? God only knows what I'd be without you. God only knows what I'd be without. God only knows what I'd be without. God only knows what.